Welcome, ICP fans, to another episode of Lowdown for the Showdown. Presented by Missy Link. Say, Missy.
Hello, hello. And welcome back, Christian.
Hey, what is up, everybody?
What is going on, Mr. Sold Out Everywhere of your book guy?
You know, it just kind of took off, man, and I'm excited about the progress. We peaked at number 5 on the Amazon Best New Sellers list, but anybody who knows me will tell you I detest losing. So anything other than number 1 is a failure to me. And I'm itching to get the book back out there so we can get it to number 1. It's got a foreword by Willie T. Ribbs this time, which is just amazing to have worked with a legend on this and to have him just give me words of encouragement. And I'm feeling ready to do it. And I'm happy to have ISCP as a part of the book sponsorship. The pages will live forever. And that's what I love about this book is that it's for the rest of history, isn't it? You know, it's a book. That's the great thing about them. So,
I mean,
awesome, unless... awesome. And you guys took my right
there. Heck yeah. Well, we are more than happy to support you in any way we can, brother. I mean, you know, we've been more than just honored to have you on for the Lowdown for the Showdown for this year and hopefully for your next years to come, especially when you become a driver and all famous and everything. But, you know, make sure that every, you know, Thursday before every race you race in, you're on Lowdown for the Showdown.
That's right. That's right. I will still do that. And you're right. You're right. You have been very blessed to have me on as long as you have. I'm kidding.
No.
I'm kidding, of course.
I will never put somebody down for really patting themselves on the back.
No, I'm just joking, man. But yeah, no, I'll still come on. Absolutely. Anytime you guys need.
Right on. And, you know, during the off season, during the silly season, you know, we expect every week. So, because, you know, you're not racing, so you have the time. So, moving on. Mrs. Track Facts, right? For Gateway.
I guess, if that's what you want to call them. So, this year, this new race, Gateway, it is being called the Bomarito.
Really, it's just a return.
Well, return, whatever. New race on the schedule this year. Bomarito Automotive Group 500 is the name of this race. And your hashtag is going to be Bomarito 500. And of course, as always, hashtag any car and hashtag any rivals. So it is a 1.25 mile short oval constructed in 1997. Your first IndyCar race was May 24th there in 1997. This year it will be 248 laps for 310 miles. Your turns 1 and 2 have 11 degree banking. Turns 1 and 2 have characteristics similar to New Hampshire Motor Speedway. Your turns 3 and 4 have 9 degree banking. Those turns are similar to Phoenix International Raceway. And the track's egg shape mimics Darlington Raceway.
I would say Montague, just backwards.
Okay. Or you could go there.
I could see that, yeah. I could see it.
That's what I see when I see it. You know, and well, so, me being a very accomplished B-license holding iRacer and everything.
Yeah. Well.
Well.
Aren't you fancy? Uh-huh.
So what license do you hold there, Christian?
Frank Fancy Pants. I don't hold a license on iRacing, Mr. Fancy Pants. I don't.
Both of you Fancy Pantses are interrupting my track facts with your iRacing junk.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Well, as Mrs. Fancy Pants, excuse me.
Excuse me. Well, if I'm
almost
Mr.
done
Fancy
for
Pants,
crying out loud. There's nothing to talk about.
I thought that's what you were. I'm sorry. Go right ahead. Continue
the only other things I have to say.
Continue the prep, the plethora of content that this track.
Like another 2 minutes of talking here. That's all.
I think
IndyCar series was here from 2001 to 2002, and you had CART here from 1997 to 2000. Let's see. Oh, they repaved the track starting June 19th, and they were finished July of this year after IndyCar teams experienced some issues with the surface during their May 2nd test. And then the only other thing we can mention is there's only three drivers who have experience on this track. You have Elio Castroneves, of course, has five starts and five top tens. He's got three top threes and a victory here. Scott Dixon only has one start here. He finished 15th in that start. And then you have Tony Kanaan, who's got four starts, two are top tens, and one's a top three. And then average lap speeds, if you want to go back 2001, 2, and 3. 2001, you had 133.379. 2002, you had 143.711. And then 2000, did I say, wait, that was wrong. 2002 was 143.711. And then 2003 was 135.286. And each race had four cautions. 2001 was four cautions for 29 laps. 2002 was four cautions for 24 laps, and 2003 was four cautions for 35 laps. And that's about the gist of it. And if I didn't mention their name, they have zero experience at this track.
Everybody
Which
else,
is everybody but three.
Yep. Right. It's going to be an interesting one.
So just put everybody's name in a little hat and just pull a name out.
Pick one out,
and there's
right.
four drivers.
Mm-mm-mm.
Except Gabby Chavez. Don't pick him.
Even though he is available.
He is. But he's so, not racing. So.
Yeah, Harding will not be there. Even though they were broken. So, all right, Mrs. Track Facts. They will get deeper as the years go by, and we will be staying there, I'm sure, because the amount of money they poured into there, there is no way IndyCar should not come in. And I'm really looking forward to seeing the fan support for the track.
I heard if you went to the St. Louis Cardinals game, I think it was yesterday, they were giving away free IndyCar tickets.
That's awesome.
Oh, wow. Wow.
How many did they give away?
I don't know. I didn't. Jeez. Didn't mention that.
Well, whoever wrote the article sucks.
Now is that reflecting poor sales for this race then?
I hope not.
If they had enough to just give away.
Well, yeah. I didn't hear Pocono doing that. And Pocono had a great fan turnout. I mean, I know on TV, I don't know how it looked on TV. I haven't seen it yet. But, I mean, you know, the stands are almost a mile long. So, but trust me, you know,
right.
the best gauge to go by is pit lane, and that's or a paddock, and that's a really big paddock, you know. And it was, you know, from hauler to garages just packed full of people. So Sunday was packed. There was a lot of people there. How is he?
Yeah, there was. I wish somebody else would come there with them. I just not that, you know, it's just kind of boring with just IndyCar there. I wish somebody else would come there with them, but you know.
Yeah, and yeah.
Like who would you like to see at Gateway?
Indy Lights, maybe.
Well, Indy Lights is at Gateway, but Pocono.
Yeah.
I mean, Indy Lights, Promo. I mean, I like to see any of them there.
I think it's too big.
It was just
kind of
like if
Indy
there wasn't
Lights,
something going on. Yeah, I mean, if there wasn't something going on with IndyCar, it was just, you know, I don't know, it's just not enough to do, mate. I don't know. Not enough on track to see. I don't know. I mean, I loved the race. I mean, it was awesome, you know, but.
Well, it did give us plenty of time to talk to people, and, you know.
So. Oh, yeah.
Because, you know, sometimes when there's so many races going on, you have no time to meet anybody.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's true. Mm-hmm.
So, I kind of liked it because it was like a IndyCar only kind of thing and, you know, 2 days or whatever. So, it was like nice and just calm and, well, Saturday was anyway. And just, you know, talking to people, meeting new people, you know, just, hey, can't beat it, right? So, and that's where we met Mike there. We met Mike there for the first time, so that was cool. And Mike's
it
good,
feels
Mike's
like
a good guy.
The first time. Mike is a good guy. I enjoyed him when we had him on the show, and our Facebook interactions have been both witty and insightful. yeah, he's a good dude.
Yeah, definitely. So, he was on the show this week, actually, just yesterday.
Oh, right on. on.
Had a good show. Alrighty, so all right, Missy Track Facts. Missy, with what you didn't have, I think you did a great job, to be honest. So I
Way to
guess
turn water into wine, Missy.
there you go.
Try,
Turn water
try.
into wine.
Somehow she got blood from a rock. I don't know how she did it, but
That's
she
right.
did it. So, all
Yeah,
right,
she's
I
Missy.
guess that moves on to the craziness of Indy Lights and the prices of drivers now, I think.
Well, Indy car, but yeah.
Right. What did I say?
Indy lights.
Indy lights.
They will be here this weekend also, but
Yes, they will. And so will Promazda.
yes.
Yep. And, not for nothing, but I love the schedule. Everything's just Saturday. It's awesome. Saturday's going to be jam-packed racing. So,
Oh, yeah.
well, everything except for IndyCar qualifying is on Friday.
well, we, it is what it is. But anyway, so at the top of your order, Joseph Newgarden, 32 clambers. Simon Pagenaud, 31. William Power. Oh, that's bad. But that was my Christian impression of an Australian accent, to be honest. So it was banned
Wow.
on purpose.
Okay.
It was my best anyway. So him, Scott Dixon at 30. Elio Castroneva says at 28. Graham Rahal's at 27. TK 26, along with Rossi.
Okay. Never mind. Keep going.
What?
Nothing. No, go.
TK
Keep
and
going.
Rossi are 26. What?
Yeah, I know.
Oh, I didn't get it wrong, did I?
No.
Okay, good. Thank you.
I'm just a little surprised that one of them, but that's okay.
Okay. We get, we have a segment
Yeah, I know.
for that. Okay, so
Got it.
interrupt me again and edit,
Oh, how's
edit.
it feel? How's it feel?
It's awesome. Along with Ryan Hunter-Reay and Hinch at 25, Takuma Sato at 24. And starting the teens, as he should, Marc-Andre. And the self-proclaimed oval specialist at Carpenter.
No, Robin Miller confirmed on the
No,
broadcast.
no, no,
What
no,
did he confirm?
no.
He kept referring to Ed Carpenter as the oval specialist.
Okay, so two people he bought into it. I don't know. So he's at 18 actually. Along with Chilton and Ed Jones at 18. Sebastian Saavedra at 17, along with Carlos Munoz. Connor Daly's at 16, along with J.R. Smollett. And Charlie Kimball is at 16. Let's see here. And then we have Gabby Chavez that don't worry about, because he's not going to be at this race. And Bourdais, who's back. And the Sasson will have to wait until next year
Oh,
if he gets a full ride at
heartbreaking.
15.
That is.
It's not heartbreaking. I'm happy Seabass is back. Right on. And
That's right, man.
that's how they were.
Deal
That's
this week.
yeah.
15 bucks.
Tell me about it. He's gonna be on the
Yep,
sewer,
absolutely.
but he's gonna be a man on a mission, man.
Yep.
Tell you what.
Always is. Hell of a
Yeah.
driver. Hell of a driver, man.
Sure is. So, Christian, who's picking who and all that good stuff for how much
Right on.
percentages?
Yeah, I got you. At the top of the leaderboard, my main man, Joe Newgarden, 100.3%. Helio Castroneves, Spider-Man, does whatever a spider can, at 89.8%. Will Power. And that was my own bad impression of my own bad impression.
No, that was actually your best impression.
with
Better, better.
82%. Scott Dixon with 70.8%. J.R. Hildebrand at 67.8%. Ryan Hunter-Reay, 62.3%. Alexander Rossi at 61.3%. Graham Rahal, 61.3%. The Oval Specialist.
It's crap.
The Oval God, as proclaimed by Robin Miller, has confirmed. Ed Carpenter,
Fine.
52.3%. TK, Tony Kanaan. I say it just because I know Missy hates it when I say that. 51% for TK. Sebastian Bourdais, welcome back,
Siva!
47.8%. Marco Andretti at 47%.
Ah.
The mayor of Hinchtown, 45.5%. Your Indy 500 winner this year, Takuma Sato, 37.8%. Simon Pagenaud, 28.5%. By the way, every time I say his name, I instantly want a baguette and some crepes, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Don't know
And
where I'm going to find
American
them in
fries.
Indianapolis at 10 o'clock, but freedom fries, right?
That's right. Oh, I
28,
screwed that
20.
up.
That's right. That's all right, man. 28.5%. Ed Jones out of Dubai, 18.8%.
Whoop, whoop.
Connor Daly, fellow diabetic, 18.3%. Max Chilton at 15.5%. Carlos Munoz at 14.8%.
Whoop, whoop.
The other type 1 diabetic like me, Charlie Kimball, 11.8%. Gabby Chavez, who will not be in action, still comes in at 11.8%, and Sebastian Saavedra at 3.5% to round out the order. Love it.
That was my
Love
favorite.
it.
That was a Sonic the Hedgehog sound effect.
Oh, is that what that was?
Yes. That was.
I
Well, you know,
didn't
you
catch
keep
that.
hitting the button, he's like, Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z, and you let him go, he's like, pew!
I need you to record that so I can wake up to it, Frank. I want that as my alarm.
That should be everybody's alarm and ringtone and notification. Just download it and use it for everything. So,
We'll get an ISCP app and it'll have sound effects you
well,
can download off of it.
I'm going to give Mike a call and make sure he, I'll send him that MP3 and he'll put it on our website as a downloadable MP3 ringtone, along with
Absolutely.
all of our social media apps and or social media. Whatever, and where can they find all that, Missy?
www.theindiesportscarpodcast.com.
Right on. It still amazes me how I plug that in someplace somehow in the weirdest way.
That
So,
was really. I think next season we should get like little downloadable stuff like that, though. So maybe some bitmojis,
oh,
for you,
I have a
Sir Fancy
Bitmoji.
Pants. I think you'd look great as a.
Yeah.
As a Sir Fancy Pants bitmoji, I think that'd be great.
I am it. I'm a green Sir Fancy Pants
Yeah,
emoji.
then let's do this. Let's do that next season.
Right on. I'm all about it.
I'll get bitmojis. It'll be great.
I'm green. Missy, what color will you be?
Blue.
How about you, Christian?
Well, now that Mrs. Fancy Pants took my answer, I'm gonna have to go with red. We'll go with red.
Right on. So like red, blue, and green. I like it.
I dig it.
I'm trying to think. I'm like racking my brain for a flag with those three colors. I have no idea which one it is. Brazil? No. Anything on
No.
red. Green, red, blue, green, red, blue, green. Okay, I'm moving along. No, I'll figure it out. So anyway, so Saavedra's getting picked. 3% and Gabby's 11. I like that, for Gabby's sake. Unfortunately, the 11% is going to be unhappy when he's not racing.
Yeah.
So anyway, start with Missy. Missy, what do you have problems with the money and the who's picking who?
I'm glad you asked.
No problem.
Got issue first off with, let's see, who we got here. Da, 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 I got that's all right, that's all right. I got issue with I guess Grant, I don't know, $27 for Grant. He's over. No, I got a problem with him. Yeah, $27. No, he hasn't done anything since Detroit. Need to drop that price down now. Alexander Rossi. All right, he got a podium, but really $26? He hasn't earned that yet. Back up there. I mean, he's priced with Tony Kanaan. Give me a break. Takuma, he's still riding off of his 500 win. He'll ride that for the rest of the season with $24.
As he should. Sorry.
Yeah, I mean, he won the 500. I get it. But as for prices, I think he's too expensive.
Is an oval.
What's that mean?
Seems to do better at them.
Oh, does he?
Well, last time I seen him win, it was at one.
Well,
Good
we
point.
just had one, and lap one, he was like 15 cars back from starting on pole.
Yeah. Wow.
It was just like, how did he get pole?
Yeah, that's true. That.
Because he start, like I said, he started almost dead last. No, he did start dead last. And I told you
Yeah, he was
that,
last.
the driver that gets pole will probably be in the last five to go because there's rubber down on the track.
You did say that.
I called it.
Yeah.
I've seen it happen 4 years in a row. So, yeah, it's going off of memory.
Right, let's see what else we got
Or
here.
knowledge, as I like to call it.
I mean, Marco's at 19. I could drop a couple bucks off of his price.
Shit. Come on, he's in the teens. I mean, come on. At least
Some oval specialist, I could drop a couple bucks off his name for being an oval specialist.
he's in the teens for crying out loud.
I don't care. And Saavedra, 17. And I'd knock a buck off of his price tag since he hit the wall last week
Missy's
by
coming
himself.
hardcore this week.
I know, I'm just
Isn't she? Isn't
I'm
she?
not
Yeah.
happy this week.
Coming off of like the best race of the year, and then she's mad.
It was a great race.
Thought so too.
Doesn't mean some of these drivers, their price should shoot up all of a sudden for whatever. Some oval specialist.
Okay,
Like,
moving
won a
on down the
damn
list,
oval
Missy.
since like
Just
10
jump.
years. All
Jump
right.
off.
All right. And Carlos, I mean, how is Connor Daly priced above Sebastian Bourdais? I mean,
He's
seriously?
just coming off of an injury. He
Yeah,
hasn't raced in how long? Come on.
I'd still pick him over Connor Daly over any
So
day of
would
the
I,
week. I mean,
but
really?
they have to.
I guess I can see the point. Poor Sebastian's gotta be. He's a steal this week at 15 bucks. Kidding me?
Indeed, he is.
It really is, yeah.
Yes, J.R. Hildebrandt. I mean, he's dropped recently, but I mean, I think he does. Well, he didn't do it. He crashed on the oval last week, but I mean, he's done pretty well on short ovals this year. I think he's podiumed on two of them. So, Charlie Campbell, I guess he's all right there. And, well, Gabby, get him off of there. What the hell?
Heck, what the heck?
And I'm done.
What about percentages of people picking?
Percentages. Let's see. What's wrong with this? Oh, I'm
Just
okay
a
with Joseph
broad
being top.
overlook would be good.
I think Carpenter's being picked way too much. Oh,
Right, Missy,
specialist.
you have the next 3 minutes to just unload. Go. Because I'm.
Specialist, really? You're the one over. How long did we discuss this already? Yes, we did. Give me a break. I mean, God,
Let her go. Let her go.
you are no oval specialist. You can't just name yourself an oval specialist. I mean, I drive on the road every day. I'm gonna call myself a road specialist. Really? I mean, give me a break. Not
A
a
new
specialist.
joke would be good.
But now, wait a minute. But wait a minute, though. Wait a minute. Now, there's got to be some kind of credence for having Robin Miller co-sign it, though, right? Does he not get some points for a notable media
Oh, that's
individual
a little bit.
co-signing it?
You really need to say
No.
that loosely.
It's blind.
He does right for Racer now.
Ed Carpenter has not won an oval race in years. To me, if you want to label yourself an oval specialist, you need more than three stinking oval wins in your dang career. And how many years is it?
I lost count.
What was the last one? Texas, right? Two years ago?
Yeah, the last race. No, whatever race it was, I remember the last race it was like the last race of the season, and it was an oval before Sonoma took over, I think. Was it Fontana, maybe?
Was it Fontana? Yeah, he has one at
Since
Fontana,
2000.
It's like 2009, 10, something like that.
No, it hadn't been that long.
2014, Texas was his
Yeah, 2 years.
last oval
Yeah.
one.
Okay,
Yeah, Texas, right.
but Sonoma was the end there. So, maybe was that the year where
That's
it
before. anymore, so you don't
He
race them
pretty
anymore.
much like locked up the championship, and it was like over. I don't know. All I know is that they were like his win was overshadowed by something else. I know that much. Like, oh yeah, by the way, Ed Carpenter won this race. But the real big story is, I remember it being something like that. I just can't put my finger on why. I'd have to
He
look.
won Fontana in 2012 and Kentucky in 2011. Those are his three oval victories in his life.
Okay. Two super speedways and Kentucky. Okay. So moving on.
That's in 15 years. Just throwing it out there. I'm just going to throw it
15
out there. For 15 years, you got three oval wins. You are not an oval specialist. You need more than one. Three freaking wins in 15 years. You
You
need
know
oval
what? So
specialist.
and
So
almost
what? So
like
he's averaging one every 5 years then? That's an average of one every 5 years. Okay.
yes.
Okay.
His stats are
So
better
he's
than
not due for
Marco's.
another
But hey,
2019. You watch
but
out.
you wait till he's been
2019.
around for
There's the
30
man.
years. He'll
I
double
know.
that.
Yes, he
He had
will.
30 years. That's right.
That'll be six
All right.
oval wins in 30 years. And
Meanwhile,
that'll be
Elio
even worse.
Castroneves has double that in 2 years of his career.
And he's the one going to sports car, apparently. Yeah, right.
Right, I'm done. All right, I'm done.
Of course, he's going to sports car. He's not a specialist, right? That's where you go when you're not a oval specialist. I'm kidding. I'm
No.
just messing with you, Missy. I'm just messing.
That's where you go when you can't make it in the series. Or most of them, anyway. I'm kind of referring to two different
Right,
people.
I promise I'm done picking on Ed Carpenter not being no oval specialist.
I think he's great on ovals. So, who else do you think? I mean, that was a Carpenter. And anything else?
Why is Marco Andretti being picked 47%? For Christ almighty.
That's
Yeah, a
like
lot of people are, yeah.
because of
A
the
lot of people are
name,
feeling Marco
man.
this
I
week.
don't understand it. I mean, you got these people at the beginning of the year. Oh, this is Marco's year. Like, yeah, what universe are you living in? Every year, that's what they say. I'm just like, I don't understand you guys.
He
No, it
does
will
have a
never
fan
be
club, you
Marco
know.
Andretti's year.
He does have a
You got
fan club.
I think with him though, he gets picked often because you got to factor in the last name and people's attachment to it. So I think at that point, the fan in you takes over the logic in you, and you just keep supporting Marco again and again and again and again, you know.
Well, that's the fun of indie rivals because you have three other picks to make up for your fandom pick, I guess.
Your
I suppose.
idiot,
Right,
your
right.
idioticism.
Moving along, Missy. I mean, anybody else that you think should have been picked more or less, whatever.
I guess I'm okay with the rest of it.
Moving on, oh,
Well,
Christian.
I guess the 11%, you guys still have, time to pick somebody else for Daddy
If you're
Chavez.
hearing this, hopefully you are.
Right. Right. Yeah.
So, Christian, how about you, buddy? You got a problem with either one, or what's going on?
I know I'm on board with Missy on most of that. Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So you hate Ed Carpenter, and you hate Marco.
No,
Wow.
I don't hate
Well, hate's a strong word. I don't hate him.
I'm
Just saying,
kidding,
he
of
ain't no oval
course.
specialist.
Over there.
I am totally joking.
That's all I'm saying.
Ed's my favorite owner. But no, I don't hate him. No. But yeah.
Loaded question. Anyways.
Yeah, right.
Alrighty. Me, I mean, okay. Missy pretty much hit on everything, except
Yeah.
for one thing. I think, where was it? Oh yeah, Ed Jones deserves to be at least in the 20s by now. Maybe like 23 under Takuma. I don't know. Rossi's
I
too
like Ed
high.
too, but
And Kimball should be lower. He should be 15, not 16. Munoz, I think, with his top 10, should be at least above Marco, at least. And Barker should be down with 15, yeah, instead of 19. But other than that, I think everything else is pretty much crazy. And yeah, they're really making it hard to make a pick or lineup lately. But I like that.
Yeah, these last 2 weeks have been brutal.
Yeah, really have. So, and then the percentages, I mean, I think Simon Pagenaud is the one I'm most surprised with people not picking. I mean, he's been so freaking consistent all year, and
Right.
New track, new asphalt. He, if Simon Pagenaud gets out in front, he's gonna stay there because he's got a great engineer. So there you go. And that's what I got with that. So, Missy, who'd you pick?
So this week I decided to go with Joseph Newgarden, Elio Castroneves,
Spider-Man, Spider-Man does
Ryan
whatever Spider-Can.
Ryan
Spider-Man.
Hunter-Reay,
Okay.
and Sebastian Bourdais.
So Seabass, RHR, New Garden, and who was the third? Or
Elio.
fourth? I mean, Elio. I already said
Those are my four drivers.
that. Okay, fair enough.
And I went average lap speed 145.120.
Okay, right on. I can't argue with that speed. Hello, Christian, who'd you pick?
I've got Will Power,
Sebas.
Sebastian Bourdais, Joseph Newgarden, and forgive me, Joseph, for not going with you last week. I should never bet against you. I realize that now. The error of my ways. And J.R. Hildebrand is my fourth pick. And I'm going with an average lap speed of 128.168.
128 point what?
168.
128. All right, so 128.16 with an 8. All right. Okay. I guess
Sir?
I think it's a great lineup, because I picked Will Power, Seabass, Joseph
Oh.
Newgarden, and Ed
Okay.
Jones.
We're in the same vein here.
Yeah, and I am happy I'm one off of you since you've been doing so well. This means I will beat you, and that will put me in first.
It all comes down to Hildebrand for me then, yeah.
Well, I'll put Ed Jones against him any day of the week. So, and my average lap speed is a 150.05 with a 1. There you go. So, yeah. Christian, I think me and you have great lineups, and Missy, yours is
Questionable this week. Shaky. It's a little
very,
shaky.
yeah, but then again, she's in a mood, so who knows? But once it's said over the air, you can't change it, so you're
No,
stuck
you
with it.
can't. That's it.
Nope. I wouldn't change it anyway. That's what it is.
All right, so any news as that has popped out that we need to address? Anybody? Anybody?
I don't think so.
I don't think
I mean,
so.
besides Bourdais in and Gutierrez is out now for the rest of the season.
Who?
Gutierrez.
Yeah.
He was trying to get you to say it with some sassone. I see what you're doing there, Frank.
Thank you. I mean, Mrs. don't doesn't get, Mrs. Fancy Pants didn't catch up on that.
No, that's all right.
Come on, Missy. You haven't given us any sasson with Gutierrez yet this year.
At all.
This is your chance.
This kid, you know what? I think this is the I think this is the time to do it.
Yep.
Come on. Come on, Missy.
What? Esteban Gutierrez.
Oh,
There you go. There's your
God.
sassol.
That. gets a triple zero from the judges there. I love a big splash with good God. There was, I mean, you were.
No, that was like if the diver did the dive, didn't do any of the flips, hit the water, and then drowned.
Never resurfaced.
Love you, Missy.
But you do get another chance. You do get another chance. So, chance number two, Missy. Christian.
Missy
Christian.
Doesn't want a chance number two.
What?
No. Missy doesn't want a chance number two.
Missy Fancy Pants over here needs to.
He's irrelevant this week.
Come on. One more time. Just one more time. With what, Christian?
With Sasson. Come on, Missy.
Come on.
I believe in you.
I know you got
the
it.
The fans believe in you.
Yeah. They're waiting for it. So come on, Missy. You got it.
Fine. How about Gutierrez Esteban?
Who is that?
That made my night. That made my night. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Backwards.
Thank you for that. Can we make that a download as well on the website?
Mike, I'm going to need two MP3 ringtones. Missy's saying, that's about to go to the backwards. And whatever the heck I did.
Oh, that's amazing.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Oh, your Sonic the Hedgehog sound.
Oh,
yeah.
That's right, yeah. Yeah, the Savager the Hedgehog, yep. You think he's going to crash this race?
95% chance, likely.
95%.
She gave him a 95% chance, likely. All right, Missy, so who are you going to give the win to in the poll to this race?
Oh, who did I pick yesterday? I don't remember.
Me neither.
I might pick somebody different today. I think I gave Joseph Newgarden the win, because I just don't. I mean, he's rocking right now. I mean, I don't see.
He really is.
I think this is his championship to lose right now.
I believe. Yeah. I fully agree. How about you, Christian?
Yeah, I agree with that. And I do think Joseph will pull out a win. Hopefully he does. He's got a lot of hungry people right behind him, though. I was watching some of the interviews, and a lot of the guys still think they can win it, you know? Which I mean, I love that. I love that about the sport. I love that never say die, no matter what it looks like, you know, type of attitude. But for sure, this is his weekend to put it away, especially because it's kind of a wild card race. You know, nobody's been there for a while, so this will be the time for him to do it. So I say Newgarden gets the win, but I don't think he gets the pole.
Who do you think gets
no,
the pole?
He has the pole.
I'm gonna go with Sato again. I'm gonna say Sato gets the pole 2 weeks in a row.
Hey, if he picks the right straw, maybe.
Right.
All right. Me, I'm saying Elio. Elio's gonna win this and pole. Paul, yep, lead every race or lead every lap, yep.
Wow, okay,
okay.
Going now, even though I didn't even pick him in Indy Rivals, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, I was getting ready. I was okay. Like, well, he's kind of missing from your lineup. If you think he's gonna,
not for mine now.
I did that. He's gonna win. I did that last week too. I didn't pick Will, and look who won. So there you go.
See that? You see that?
All right. All right, so all right. I think that's all the segments that we normally have for the show.
Quick question.
What's that?
Before we do sign off, where did Billy finish in the standings from last week's race?
Oh boy. I guess
I know he's back in college. Have a great year, buddy.
Yeah, more power to him.
Back
and
in school.
Yeah.
But don't forget to take a break from the books to listen to me tell you how bad you did at Indie Rivals last week. All right, so Frank, go ahead and tell me where did Billy finish in relation to the rest of us?
Well, I'm glad you asked because I had that. I had it pulled up right away.
Yeah, you did.
Okay, so
On deck, Frank had it on deck, right?
it's right here. It's right here. Let's see. No, it's not. Oh boy, I stink.
Cash finished first with
All right.
138 points. Then you had Joe M with 134 points. Troy H with 128, tied with Becky J for 128, but he did way better on his average lap speed. And then in fifth, you had Christian with 121 points, followed by Missy Lynx with 117. And you had Ed B with 115 and Jacob K with 115. But Ed B outdid him on lap speed. And then you had Jane H with 114, Rick S with 112, Adrian IndyCar UK with 111, Eric P with 111, Philip M with 110, Cody C 108, Christina C 108, Ethan A 106, Lindsay B 106, Matthew E 104, Gregory M 102, Billy L 100 at 20th. And then you had Connor M at 98, Brett F 97, Mike H 97, Mike J 96, Derek S 94. I'm sure Frank's here somewhere. Ken H 94, Thomas B at 90, Mark V 89, Gregory M 89, Brian C 57, Chris D 57. Last but certainly not least, Links.
Last and definitely least, I forgot to hit save, okay? I forgot to hit save on my lineups, everybody. That's my fault. And at least I know the other two in the league that didn't hit save or tried. And I will be on Twitter after the show yelling at them. Well, I think I'll just call DeHardy and to yell at him personally. But I just want to thank everybody that's been on our league. I mean, how many females do we have on the league? We have at least it's a great amount. It's like 3/4 of the league is females. It's awesome. You know, a lot of
That is
women
pretty cool.
are getting into IndyCar, and it's great to see. And you know what? I think Missy Lynx has something to do with that.
That's right.
Yay.
That's right. That's right. You know. And Missy, why did you say my name with such authority? You put some force behind it. You like Christian A. That was
Well, look what
what
she
was
did
How
with
did you
that
finish 3
carpenter.
points in front of me, you bum?
Oh no! Oh
That's
no!
okay. I'm a friend of where it matters. Total points for the year.
Now we have to remember,
This
this is only
man did two
my.
tours in Iraq and she just called you a bum.
She sure did. She sure did. 912 days I spent out
Yeah.
there, and she sure did.
This is the respect you get for beating her in Indy Rivals. You're a bum.
And you're a That's right. That's right. You know. No, but that's okay. That's okay because
Nothing above for you.
I'm a racer now, so it's okay. No, that's why this is all
I
right, you
appreciate
know.
your sacrifice and all, you bum.
You bum.
I didn't make you go out there. It's your choice, you bum.
Exactly. I love it. I love it. But I tell you what, if I keep this up, I think next year I've got a legitimate shot. If I was able to do all the races, you know, I think I've got a legitimate shot next year of
You're definitely good at
taking
it.
it all home.
You do have a knack for it. I'll give you that. You do have a knack for it.
Well, thank you, sir.
I
Thank you.
don't, and that's why I can tell who does because, you know, it's easier to see what you don't have compared to people who do than it is for people who do have it than people who do. You know what I mean? If that made it any sense
I hear.
whatsoever. I think it did, actually.
Yeah, it did. It
Okay,
did.
cool.
Sure.
you know what? And one thing I will say is the upcoming race, Missy, is Gateway, right?
I hope so. We just did a whole show on
I know. And we'll be there, right?
it. Yes, we will.
Right on. I just wanted to throw out there. So if anybody wants to say hi, just throw us a DM and we'll be happy to meet up with you. So we'll be there Saturday, all day Saturday. And yeah, hit us up. Always happy to say hello to everybody, so don't be shy. And
Sure.
and again, Christian, your book, it is right now sold out, but it will be coming back
Oh,
around.
it's
And
yes, it's coming back with a vengeance
right on.
here in the next week.
You want to throw out the
Yeah,
name?
so it'll be back up on Amazon .com, and following that, it will be the print version will be in Barnes and Noble, as well as Books a Million and a couple of other smaller bookstores as well, which I appreciate all of them, and happy to have it up on a shelf. It's a good read. I'm even glad that Willie T. Ribbs thought it was a good read as well. I was kind of nervous sending it off to him to see what he thought about it, but he just said, "Man, that's a hell of a story."
That's awesome.
And so thank you. So yeah, this will be cool.
That is awesome. Very awesome.
And happy to
So,
have ISCP on too, man.
oh, well, that's the big one. But I mean, Willie T. Ribbs, close second. I mean, come So, but definitely.
Yeah, close second. That's right.
So, everybody, just to keep your eyes peeled for what's the name of the book there?
It's My Life and Story, The Outside Groove by Cosby Media Productions.
Right on. So, everybody put that on your wish list, or I think Amazon has that, don't they? So, yeah,
Yes, they do.
throw it on there. And
That's right.
your Facebook, so they can even find a link to it. I'm sure that you have there on there.
Sure. It's Christian with a K, RISTIAN, last name ALEIXO. Both my fan page and my personal page are named the exact same thing. So go ahead and add me as a friend. Go ahead and like the fan page as well, and I'll keep everybody updated on it. And yeah, looking forward
Awesome.
to seeing the support. Let's get this thing to number one, man.
That's what I'm gonna
I hate
say.
that. Number five. I was mad,
I
man.
know. Out
I
of
was
all the
hurt.
authors that are on Amazon, I mean, only number five. I mean,
Five?
so
Five?
disappointed in you, dude.
Well, no, because I mean, everybody else thought I did like a great job. They were just like, "Oh, there's hundreds of books out there. You're number five." I was like, "No. I don't think you guys know me very well. No. I don't think you know me very well. I'm not happy with that." So,
Number five is
and I
like
and I
last place.
and I it is anything after first
You're
is
like
last
fifth
place,
worst.
as far as I'm
Fourth
concerned.
worst.
Right,
Exactly.
man. So,
Right.
yeah, I'm excited. Let's get this thing to number one for sure.
And more power to you, man. Looking forward to and can't couldn't be more proud of you, brother. Really.
Thanks, bud. Thank you.
And Missy, I think on that positive note.
And on that note, you know that I know that Frank and Christian know nobody was safe for Missy this week, you know?
The wrath. The wrath.
Beep beep.